Hello everyone, and welcome back to, for once, shoot, America Isn't the Bad Guy Simulator.exe. Yeah, Tom Clancy, you know, he built a universe where America...
Hey people, put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pat Katari and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. We need to focus and get this done quick before we get stuck between local politics and a firestorm of cartel bullets. First objective, track down that Santa Blanca lieutenant so we can find Amaru.
Hoo-ah.
Right, so, you may have noticed a bit of the funnies happening. We are American Special Forces in South America. I can't even. Supporting communist rebels against the drug cartel. That's something that has famously never bitten America in the rear end. Oh good, I have no crates, so I don't have to loot box. Don't I have... I should have a rifle from... Yeah, the division rifle, not that good. Yee, look at me with my 50 cal. Alright, let's grab this Jeep and dippity dip.
Buckle up, people.
I guess I should play the radio. Because it does provide context for the world at large after you've done certain things.
DJ Perico and Santa Blanca Radio issuing a safety reminder to all you sicarios out there. Please remember to keep your weapons on safe unless you're trying to shoot somebody. I know. You're putting your weapon on safe is kind of like flossing your teeth. You know you're supposed to do it, but who the fuck really, banda? But the shit that could go down when you don't put your weapon on safe is a hell of a lot worse than the gingivitis you get from not flossing. I mean, you don't want to be the asshole who accidentally shoots your homie in the leg or something. Don't mind me. Or imagine being the motherfucker who gives away his position when hunting down some rebels. Do not be that guy. Practice safe handling of your firearms. Without a question.
So, I should go on to explain what my game plan is going to be going forward. I will be taking down the entire security apparatus first. Because it will make it harder for, the cartel to effectively fight my squad and I. Although that will mean going into some of the hardest areas of the game immediately. Because there are different difficulty levels. So, Itaqua has one skull. Oroko, two. Oh, it appears to be raining outside in real life. So you're supposed to kind of expand outward, but because I am a galaxy brain and hate myself, I'm just gonna skip right through and do some stuff that I shouldn't. Well, not so much that I shouldn't. It's just not best to do early on because you don't have as good skills. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna pause here. Yeah, we'll be fine.
Drone is there.
No, I wanted the binoculars. So, gameplay-wise, imagine if this was a mashup of GTA 5, Far Cry, and, well, Ghost Recon. That's really the best way to explain it.
Don't want to spook the target. Switch to suppressors.
Way heavy there.
Got eyes on the target. Let's move.
You should never not have the suppressor, unless you have to intentionally go loud. Then, you know, go loud and go proud.
Just spotted one with submachine guns. I'm spotting another tango.
So you don't have to use a synchronized shot here. I mean, it's easier.
Clear over here.
Oh yeah, supplies. Make sure you tag them.
Leave a marker so the rebels can pick up these supplies.
It's good because you use the supplies to.
We got hostiles.
Let me go over there. You use the supplies to upgrade your skills.
In the area.
Very useful.
Everybody hold up, we got hostiles in the area.
Hey, we got a narco. There, in the watchtower.
The SB lieutenant should be just out and about. Oh my god, only 4x zoom, okay. Yeah, 50 cal will definitely kill you with a shot to the arm.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. ¿Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
Absolutely delusional.
Amaru's an old man. He's not going to last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead.
Maybe, maybe not. Amaru's a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what he knows.
We can't afford to take any chances. There's too much riding on this. Let's move. Let's get moving. The cartel ain't gonna wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
Actually, they will. But... there's probably something I want in that armory. Also, more supplies that I need to tag. Comms equipment. Yeah, there's a lot of this in this game. Anything I can steal here? That would be your Santa Blanca advert on why not to with the cartel.
Shit,
or steal from it.
Sueño. The sicarios have found the escaped prisoner in the village of Culta.
What a wonderful name for a town. They were protecting him.
Si. The village is known to Unidad as a haven for rebels.
Why do these rebels even bother? Kill them all. The whole village. Visit divine wrath upon Culta. And
absolutely beautiful.
Claro, al rato.
Delusional. terribly sorry for that. My brother decided to interrupt me. Having roommates, such fun.
Ready? Open fire.
I'm opening fire. Say the word.
Easy. Come in.
Well, that
either
was messy
I walk
as shit.
Away from here with answers, or, your ears. The choice is yours.
I ain't no snitch, but I'll tell you this one thing.
I'll drive.
Okay, I'm back. Waiting to hear back about a job. Hopefully, if you're watching this in the future, I will be employed. Oh my god, these cars. Just slippity-dippity. They're slippier than a greased-up fish on Friday. Wait, no, that doesn't make sense. Oh my giddy aunt. Yeah, fun fact about the civilian AI, they just love to jump into the road. Look at that! Is that another SB lieutenant? It's so tempting, but like, I can't risk them. Look at that Lambo. But legally distinct from a Lambo because they didn't want to pay for the copyrights.
Another tango. Got a third. I got another. That's five.
Two Sicarios. There, and the barn. Coming up on a Toyo farm. Remember, a lot of these Sicarios are ex-military.
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go.
Bingo.
We're good.
Oh, also you can do things like, EMPing generators with your drone in the future, or shooting out lights, like, you know, some thought was put into this game, which is surprising for Ubisoft.
Are you Amaru?
What's left of him anyway?
Come on, we're getting you out of here.
Chimkin. Thanks for leaving this helicopter here, or Santa Blanca.
Sure are a lot of lights and switches up here.
You really ought to let me drive.
Where are you taking me?
Back to your friends.
Entonces Pacatari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros, the young fool.
Take it up with him, senor.
Some sadly removed, but absolutely god-tier, event was there was a Predator, game mode, or event, encounter, at one point, and the lead-up to it was great. You know, there was the dead bodies, the dismembered, the picked clean things. You know, a Unidad guy getting snatched out from the middle of nowhere. What weapon is this?
Awesome.
M48-5. What else about the... sadly, then it just became a game of whack-a-mole, which was really annoying. But anyway, let's let Amaru... Holy shit, dude, you've seen better days.
Hurt? Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Sí, Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe four. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock. Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through.
There were four people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel. Ricky? And the last two were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency, and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchan named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were four people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop, for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.